Hello and thank you for your interest in the U.S. Highway 51 Stoughton Road North Corridor Study. The following recorded presentation provides an overview of the study purpose and need, the alternative concepts developed throughout the corridor, and the next steps for the study moving forward. Please note that this recording is an abbreviated version of the live presentation given at the September 27th public involvement meeting. The presentation slides shown at that September 27th meeting can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. On this slide is an overview map showing the limits of the study. The study starts just south of the State Highway 30 interchange in the city of Madison and extends approximately 5.5 miles north to just south of the I-39/90/94 interchange in the town of Burke. At the previous public involvement meeting in October 2022, the northern study limit had extended to State Highway 19. Since that meeting, it was determined that the section of U.S. Highway 51 north of the interstate would be evaluated as part of a separate I-39/90/94 interstate study that extends from the city of Madison to the Wisconsin Dells. Within the study area, U.S. Highway 51 is a primary north-south route through the east side of the city of Madison, providing access to commercial businesses and nearby neighborhoods. Traffic safety and operations are affected by the 14 intersections located within the corridor, which are listed on this slide. Please note that while the Donteal Road intersection is located within the study limits, due to its close proximity to the I-39 interchange, it will be evaluated as part of the I-39/90/94 interstate study. The existing corridor can be split into three sections based on the look and feel of Stoughton Road in each area. The south section extends from south of State Highway 30 to south of East Washington Avenue and is shown in yellow on the map. It has three lanes in each direction and has signalized intersections at the State Highway 30 ramps and the Lexington Avenue Commercial Avenue intersection. The speed limit in this section is 45 miles per hour. The central section extends from East Washington Avenue to Kinsman Boulevard and is shown in red. It has two to three lanes in each direction and signalized intersections at East Washington Avenue, Anderson Street, and Kinsman Boulevard. This section is heavily used by bicycles and pedestrians due to nearby neighborhoods and Madison College. This section of the corridor also has several businesses with direct access onto U.S. Highway 51. The speed limit in this section is primarily 35 miles per hour, although the speed limit does change to 45 miles per hour just south of Kinsman Boulevard. The north section extends from Kinsman Boulevard to just south of the interstate and is shown in blue. It has two travel lanes in each direction and has a combination of signalized and unsignalized intersections. The speed limit in this section varies from 45 to 55 miles per hour. This slide provides a high-level overview of the study purpose and need. Every study develops a purpose statement to summarize the objective of the study and the needs it will address. The purpose of the U.S. Highway 51 North study is to accommodate existing and future travel demand with a focus on safety issues that affect travel on Stoughton Road. The graphic gives a summary of the primary issues and concerns that the study would look to address. They include safety, primarily at intersections and for bicycles and pedestrians, travel demand, which includes addressing traffic congestion on the corridor, and infrastructure, including addressing geometric deficiencies and poor pavement condition. These needs, along with input from stakeholders, will drive the development and refinement of the improvement alternatives and will also be a key factor in the selection of a preferred construction alternative. More information on the corridor needs can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. Over the past several months, the study team has been working to develop high-level concepts that address the study's purpose and need. Concepts that optimize safety and existing capacity while limiting impacts to the surrounding area have been developed, along with potential improvements to the bicycle and pedestrian network. It is important to note that capacity expansion, or adding additional lanes to the U.S. Highway 51 mainline throughout the corridor, is not anticipated. Therefore, the concepts focus on intersection areas. The concepts that will be discussed in more detail in this summary presentation include the State Highway 30 interchange, the Lexington Commercial Avenue intersection, and the East Washington Avenue intersection. These locations were selected for more detailed discussion here because some of the concepts are less common and additional explanation may provide better understanding for stakeholders. Potential bicycle and pedestrian accommodations are shown in orange on the slides. In general, an all ages and abilities shared use path accommodation is proposed on the east side of US Highway 51 that would extend from State Highway 30 to County Highway CV. In addition, bicycle and pedestrian accommodations such as crosswalks are proposed at all signalized intersections between State Highway 30 and Hepker Road. More details on the proposed bicycle and pedestrian accommodations can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. Beginning at State Highway 30, the existing condition is a diamond interchange with signalized ramp intersections located on US Highway 51. There are two concepts that are being evaluated at this interchange. The first concept maintains the existing diamond interchange with improvements to ramp intersections, such as adding or extending turn lanes where needed. The second concept is a diverging diamond interchange, or DDI. The DDI would shift traffic between the US Highway 51 ramp intersections to better accommodate the high volume of left-turning vehicles onto State Highway 30. US Highway 51 traffic would cross to the opposite side of the road through the interchange to allow for free flow movement of the left-turning traffic onto the ramps, thereby minimizing the amount of time traffic is stopped at signals. Additional information on how a DDI works, including a handout and video, can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. Please note that both of the State Highway 30 concepts would keep the existing State Highway 30 bridges over US Highway 51. Moving north to the Lexington Avenue-Commercial Avenue intersection. The existing condition is a signalized intersection with a railroad crossing located approximately 350 feet to the south. The City of Madison is currently studying the potential for inner-city rail service that would utilize this rail line in the future. Due to the possibility of more frequent and higher-speed train crossings, options to raise US Highway 51 over the railroad tracks are being considered. There are three concepts being evaluated in this area. The first concept maintains the existing signalized intersection with improvements, such as adding or extending turn lanes where needed. The second concept would raise US Highway 51 over the railroad and a new roadway connecting Lexington Avenue and Commercial Avenue, which would be constructed just to the north of the railroad crossing. This would allow US Highway 51 traffic to freely flow between State Highway 30 and East Washington Avenue. Access to and from US Highway 51 would come from two new right-in, right-out intersections located north and south of the new roadway. As an example, if someone was traveling southbound on US Highway 51 and they wanted to travel to Walmart, they would turn right at the right-in, right-out intersection, then turn left onto the new roadway connection and go underneath US Highway 51, and then turn left into Walmart. Likewise, if someone was traveling north on US Highway 51 and wanted to go to Lexington Avenue, they would turn right at the right-in, right-out intersection, then turn left onto Commercial Avenue, go under US Highway 51, and then turn left onto Lexington Avenue. The third concept would also raise US Highway 51 over the railroad and construct a new roadway connection just north of the railroad crossing. Commercial Avenue would be extended to the north and intersect US Highway 51 at a signalized intersection. Access to and from US Highway 51 would come from this intersection. For example, if someone was traveling southbound on US Highway 51 and wanted to travel to Walmart, they would make a left on Commercial Avenue and follow it to the Walmart entrance. Likewise, if someone was traveling northbound on US Highway 51 and wanted to go to Lexington Avenue, they would turn right at Commercial Avenue, then make another right onto the new roadway, go underneath US Highway 51, and then turn left on Lexington Avenue. The final intersection described in detail in this summary presentation is East Washington Avenue. The existing condition is a signalized intersection located in a dense urban area. There are four concepts being evaluated at this location. The first concept maintains the existing signalized intersection with improvements such as adding through or turn lanes where needed and realigning the intersection angle. The second concept is a quadrant intersection. With this concept, left turns would not be allowed at the U.S. Highway 51 and East Washington Avenue intersection. Instead, the left turns would be made by utilizing a new roadway located in the southwest quadrant between two new closely spaced signalized intersections. As an example, if someone was traveling southbound on Stoughton Road and wanted to go east on East Washington Avenue, they would travel south straight through the intersection where they would normally turn left and then turn right at the new intersection to the south. They would then continue along the new roadway, make a right turn at the Schmiedeman Avenue intersection, and proceed to the east. Likewise, if someone was traveling west on East Washington Avenue and wanted to go south on U.S. Highway 51, they would travel west straight through the intersection where they would normally turn left, then make a left turn at the Schmiedeman Avenue intersection, continue along the new roadway to the intersection to the south, and turn right. Additional information on how a quadrant intersection works can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. The third concept is a jug handle in the southwest quadrant of the U.S. Highway 51 and East Washington Avenue intersection. This concept is similar to the existing Mineral Point Road and Junction Road intersection on Madison's west side. For the jug handle, southbound U.S. Highway 51 traffic would travel over East Washington Avenue. Similar to the quadrant concept, a new roadway located in the southwest quadrant between two new closely spaced signalized intersections is needed for specific turning movements. As an example, if someone was traveling southbound on Stoughton Road and wanted to go east on East Washington Avenue, they would travel south over East Washington Avenue, then turn right at the new intersection to the south, continue along the new roadway, make a right turn at the new intersection to the west, and then proceed to the east. Likewise, if someone was traveling west on East Washington Avenue and wanted to go south on U.S. Highway 51, they would travel west straight through the U.S. Highway 51 and East Washington Avenue intersection, then make a left turn at the new intersection to the west, proceed to the new intersection to the south, and turn right. Additional information on how the jug handle works can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. The fourth concept is a tight diamond interchange. With this concept, U.S. Highway 51 would go under East Washington Avenue. U.S. Highway 51 traffic would be free flow, and access to and from U.S. Highway 51 would come from two new signalized ramp intersections located on East Washington Avenue. That concludes the more detailed discussion on the alternative concepts. A general overview of the concepts at the other intersections on the corridor is provided on the next two slides. At the Anderson Street, Pierstorf Street, and Amelia Earhart Drive intersections, the only proposed concept maintains the existing intersection configuration with improvements such as adding or extending turn lanes where needed. At Kinsman Boulevard, two concepts are being considered. The first concept maintains the existing signalized intersection with improvements such as adding or extending turn lanes. The second concept would convert the intersection to a roundabout. At Reeder Road, the proposed concept maintains the existing intersection. One additional option being considered is constructing a restricted crossing U-turn, or R-cut, approximately 900 feet north of the intersection. This would allow vehicles to make a U-turn to travel southbound on U.S. Highway 51. Currently, many drivers make this U-turn at Amelia Earhart Drive. At the Acker Road and County Highway CV intersections, the only proposed concept maintains the existing intersection configuration with improvements such as adding or extending turn lanes where needed. At the County Highway CV intersection, it is anticipated that a third eastbound County Highway CV to northbound U.S. Highway 51 left turn lane would be needed, due in part to the high volume of semi-truck traffic in the area. This would require an additional travel lane on northbound U.S. Highway 51 to the I-39/90/94 interchange. At Hanson Road, two concepts are being considered. The first concept maintains the existing intersection with improvements such as adding acceleration and deceleration lanes. The second concept is a restricted left turn intersection, which means vehicles traveling southbound on U.S. Highway 51 would not be able to make a left turn onto Hanson Road. This movement could instead be made at the Hepker Road intersection to the north. Two concepts are being considered at Hepker Road. The first concept maintains the existing signalized intersection with improvements, such as adding or extending turn lanes where needed. The second concept would convert the intersection to a roundabout. As mentioned previously, the Donteal Road intersection will be evaluated as part of the I-39/90/94 Interstate Study. That concludes the general overview of the other intersections on the corridor. Please note that more detailed information on all the concepts under consideration can be found on the public involvement page of the study website. A high-level study schedule is shown on this slide. Based on the feedback received from this round of public involvement, the alternative concepts developed throughout the corridor will be refined and more detailed development of the alternatives will begin. This is expected to occur through the end of 2023 and into 2024. In early 2024, a public involvement meeting will be held to present and get feedback on the detailed alternatives and the potential impacts of those alternatives. Based on that feedback, the study team will identify a preferred construction alternative in the spring of 2024. The environmental document for the study will be published in the fall of 2024, and that will be followed by a public hearing. The study is anticipated to be completed in early 2025. Once the study is completed, the project would then be eligible to be approved for final design and construction. If that occurs, the earliest the construction of a preferred alternative is anticipated is the late 2020s. Please consider providing feedback regarding the proposed study purpose and need and the alternative concepts developed throughout the corridor. There's an online comment form and survey available on the public involvement page of the study website. You may also contact Wisconsin DOT Project Manager Jeff Behrens with any questions or comments you may have. Please complete the online survey and submit any comments by October 27, 2023. Thank you for viewing this presentation. We appreciate your interest in the U.S. Highway 51 Stoughton Road North study, and we look forward to receiving your input as we continue the study process.